Whiskey Jason here, whiskey from the viewpoint of an American over here in Germany tasting rare and exotic whiskies. Today I have a single cask from a whiskey tuber in Germany. His name is Whiskey Babbler. The word Babbler means someone who talks and talks and talks. Maybe we could call him Whiskey Rambler. All right, so Whiskey Babbler is a good friend of mine. His name is Norman. I've known him for a few years now. We've done a lot of live streams. Unfortunately, I don't think he has any content in English, but he's done various just single cask bottlings. In the US, we'd call him like a store pick, so a barrel pick. And over here, you can also do picks and bring them over to your country if you're in Europe and then sell them. In this case, he's selling them to a store in Frankfurt. If you're ever in Frankfurt, Germany, go to Whiskey for Live. Say hi to Frank Yeager from me and say he knows Jason. And you'll find an interesting sort of interesting range of American whiskeys, small but fine. Some of them are the ones I import over here together with my partners and Ben. And he has a great selection of single malt, independently bottled whiskeys. All right, and so now, I actually received just a few weeks ago a nice little email from Norman, and he said there's going to be a new independently bottled Glendullan with his name on it. This is a 13-year-old product. Now, this is whiskey base number 234319. This is 65 euros. So I have a rule of thumb. It's not perfect, but my rule of thumb is if it's cask strength, independently bottled, and single barrel, I might be willing to pay 10 euros per year for that. So 13-year-old Glendullan, this is a Diageo distillery, usually goes into the Singleton. So we have Dufftown, we have Glen Ord, and we have Glendullan. Those are the three that all Singleton from Diageo. And this, now I lost my train of thought. Very, very good, Jason. So this, oh yeah, this 13-year-old whiskey should be at a price, or could be at a price today of 130 euros. Doesn't have to be, but could be. This is 65. So this is half of that price where I go, ouch. So this is something I can recommend. Now, there's only 249 bottles. This was cask number 313224, and it's a bourbon hogshead. I'm never really sure what a bourbon hogshead is. Is that a first fill hogshead, therefore they can call it a bourbon hogshead? Is it a hogshead just made out of ex-bourbon casks and have been used 20 times? So, this was distilled on the 14th of October 2009. By the way, of Norman, that's his birth date. So he celebrates every year on the 14th of October his birthday, and so this was actually distilled on that date, which makes it very, very special. And it was bottled on the 21st of April, 2023. So I got over here fairly quickly. So we now have the middle of July where I'm doing this video. So who knows when it's going to happen. You might see it in September. Who knows? All right. So it's a 13-year-old product, 54.4%. Now, this is natural color. This is here. No coloring added, as I mentioned, non-chilled filtered. And very, very nicely done from Signatory Vintage. When I bought the bottle, I decided to go online and look at the shop, whiskeyforlife.de, and what else I could buy with this. Unfortunately, I was uninformed just a day or two earlier. His newest from Whiskey for Life in Frankfurt, the newest range with aqua, with the three fish, different types of fish there on the labels had just dropped. I looked at them and said, I've never seen those before. And then my eye caught this bottle. It's called Ease, and it's a Glengarry, and it's a single cask. It's only 10 years of age. It is 59.8%, 79 euros. This is 65, and it's a bourbon barrel matured whiskey. Now, in my personal opinion, everyone usually knows this, but I'm still going to repeat myself here, is that when you take a whiskey, I don't care from which distillate you take, from which distillery, it could be Irish, it could be German, it could be American, it could be Scottish, it could be from the wherever, as long as it's not peated, and you put it in a first fill Pedro Ximenez PX sherry butt, you leave it sit there for 4 years, it doesn't matter where it comes from, it's going to basically taste the same. Because the Pedro Jimenez just totally bulldozers everything on taste that was there otherwise. But on the other hand, if you actually use hogsheads, bourbon barrels, the distillery character gets to shine through. Because that finishing cask or that maturation cask does not cover up everything else that's going on. All right, it's like you're listening to maybe a grasshopper and then the ambulance or the police car drives by. It's like, I can't hear anything else. It just totally blurs out everything else. But if you have this, it's like a nice electric car just goes by and then it's like, oh, look at that. I can still hear everything. All right, always I try to throw in a car analogy every once in a while. On the nose. Now, Glendullan is not known for being a powerful, spicy whiskey, single malt whiskey. Some people actually call it the softest of the three from Diageo's Singleton brand. They produce 5 million liters a year. Their total capacity, they're running 24/7. And it's very, very difficult at the moment. I have two good friends. They work together. They are independent bottlers here in Germany. And they are trying to get some of the Diageo casks they bought 5, 8, 10 years ago and have those casks get a sample so they can see if it's ready to be filled or not. And if they can't get the sample, which is often the case with Diageo at the moment, just getting the cask out of the warehouse so that it can be bottled no matter what. All right. And even Diageo is like, nope. So we don't have manpower for that. We're barely getting our casks out of the warehouse, and we're not going to worry about these casks we don't own anymore. So if you want to hire someone, you want to pay us to let them get in, we'll talk about that. But and he's like, but it's always been this way. And Diageo's like, we don't have enough people at the moment for our own warehouses. And someone asked recently is, don't they taste the whiskeys after they put it in the warehouse and see when it goes in the wrong direction or something like that? No, they don't. Very often they don't. And that's something that's very, very unbelievable for a lot of other people. But don't forget, we have millions and millions of casks from Diageo alone maturing in warehouses all over Scotland. All right, so let's skip that topic. Let's go back to this. One of the very interesting parts of this was last year, October 2022, Norman, the Whisky Babbler, he was in Scotland, and he actually tried this cask. He has a picture of this cask, and he liked it. And then later on, this cask was offered to him and his partner here, Fun Whiskey for Life, together with Signature Vintage, and he just jumped on it. He said, I know that cask. Oh, yeah, I'll try that. I'll buy that, and I'll bottle it. So that was very, very good. So about once every other year, he actually buys a cask and then he finds a partner and then he can act. One time he did a partial cask bottling and then this time he did the whole cask. 249 is not a lot from a 250 liter hogshead. There was a slight leak in there and there was some alcohol and of course water that somehow managed to escape our wonderful glass that we now have this in here. All right, so very light, very malty, very nice. This, on the other hand, Glengarry has a little bit more of a depth, has a little bit more of a character, has a little bit more spice going on here. I like Glengarry as a independently bottled, bourbon cask matured product. Just ticks a lot of my boxes. All right, so let's try these first. Whiskey base 234319. 65 euros. Great price. Norman, thank you. One of the first things that comes to mind is this is one of these old school type of whiskeys. This is what the whiskey drinkers, the whiskey connoisseurs 20 years ago were drinking. Why do I say 20 years ago? 20 years ago, it was right around the time where Paxillette was no longer really allowed. Sherry wasn't the big thing it is today. And they were drinking a lot of hogshead matured single malt from different distilleries. Back then, we would talk about the first row distilleries, would be a Macallan, would be maybe a Glenlivet, a Glenfock, maybe a Glenfockless, maybe a Glen Fiddy, first row. Second row would be a lot of the Diageo workhorses, so the Glen Ords, the Glendullan, maybe even Kleinlich could be considered. I don't know. So I'm not perfect on the tiers here. And then there was a third row, which no one was talking about, and so on. And so this was absolutely something that was not unusual 20 years ago. Norman has been drinking and enjoying whiskey together with Frank Yeager in Frankfurt now for the past, I would say, 15 years, and it might be going on 20 years. So they have a long, long friendship there, and he knows his stuff. And the Whisky Babbler, his favorite whiskey fair is Limburg. Not because you get to meet the people there, yes, as well, but you get to try that old stuff. And Norman, he loves to buy bottles from the 70s and the 80s. Not maybe back then they were like 25 to 30 day mark, and today he's paying 50 to 80 euros for those. But that old bottle experience, we call it old bottle flavor in Germany, but old bottle experience, he just loves that. He'll have an old Highland Park, he'll have an old whatever. Now, old Macallans he cannot afford, nor should you, but there are certain things that are on auction that like nobody wants, especially with a damaged label, maybe even the neck pour, the neck level's gone down a little bit, and he says, I'll just bid this. And he really, really enjoys those old things. And this is what it tastes like. There's that, there's a depth in there, there's a little bit of a dunnage moment, there's a little bit of tartness in there, there's a little bit of barley sweetness, there's a tiny little bit of melon. I would even call a little bit of a, we call them digestive biscuits. Butter cakes over here in Germany, butter cakes, butter crackers, butter biscuits. Crackers was wrong, biscuits is more of a cookie than anything else. And graham crackers for you. And in the States, and this is a very nice whiskey. This is like a C-plus whiskey. Now, I'm not euphoric about it. It's not something I'm going to go, wow, but I like it. It's very, very nice. It's very, very solid. All right, so did I miss anything? A little bit of, oh yeah, I forgot the apple and the pear. There's a sliced apple, apple and pear. That's very good. The alcohol is not the problem at all. Very, very nicely integrated. You almost want to chew it a little bit. Good. I'm going to dilute it a little bit, bring it down with water here. So it is almost 55%, so take it down to about 46-48%. The apple comes through a lot more. Tiny little bit sweeter, which is not unusual. Very light floral moment, almost like a daisy type of moment, like a white rose. But there is a spice, there is a depth, there is a balance to this whiskey. Well done, Babbler. I'm going to give it a solid C for value for money. I think you could have said 95 and it still would have sold out. Thank you very much for making available, I'm sorry, making affordable single malt, cask strength, independently bottled Glendullan accessible for us in Germany at an affordable price. Well done. Now, as I said, I just bought this so I can have two bottles, save a little bit postage. And I enjoy Glengarry, so let's just try this in comparison. If I had the choice between these two, and if I were allowed to put my name on one of these and only one of these, it'd be here. This has more flavor depth. This has more complexity. There's a sweetness and a softness here This has more of that Glengarry spice. So nice. I like this a lot. All right. This is very, very good. This is a tad better in my opinion. But I just love the fact that we can try these different whiskeys from Bourbon Hogshead, Bourbon Barrel, and really get a feel for that distillery character more. So, my question of the day is, in the English-speaking world, a lot of our different whiskey tubers have done so-called store picks. I think I have, wait a second, can I show this here? Wrong place. I have it here. So, I've been saving this. So I have, for example, here, a Wilderness Trail. It's Bourbon Night, store pick. And this was their 4-year, 3-month, so-and-so. And it's a bourbon pick here from, it's Bourbon Night from Chad and Sarah. So what other whiskey tubers actually have had barrel picks? And which ones have you had the privilege of trying? Thank you very much for watching, liking, subscribing, telling others, and sharing. See you real soon. Whiskey Jason here. Nice whiskey. C+, value for money, solid C. Bye-bye.